At its core, Pokemon Snap and New Pokemon Snap are basically the same. It's on rails, you have items at your disposal to help you get better pictures, and at the end, your photos are graded by the professor. But it's not entirely accurate to say that New Pokemon Snap is identical to its predecessor. So in this video, I'll be breaking down 6 of the biggest changes in New Pokemon Snap compared to the original. If you like this video, then consider dropping a like and subscribing. We'd appreciate it. Anyways, on to the changes. Number 1, Night Courses. You're still a kid in this game, but this time the adults let you go out at night. New to New Pokemon Snap are night versions of courses. At night, you'll encounter different Pokemon and a variety of new poses for Pokemon that were there during the day. For example, this guy who was walking around during the day is now sleeping. How cute. Night courses more or less run down the same track as their day counterpart, but it's a nice touch that makes things more dynamic as you comb through each course for all it has to offer. But you might be wondering, how do you unlock night courses? Number 2, Research Levels. To unlock night courses and, for the most part, progress the story, you need to increase your research level on any given course, which is also new this time around. Think of a new research level as something akin to a World 1-2 in Mario, although some are more similar than others. The next research level sometimes adds new routes, but mainly adds new Pokemon and different poses and actions for existing ones, much like the night courses. At the end of a course, all your photos are graded by the professor like in the original game, and with enough points, you'll be able to access the next research level. If you are trying to unlock the next research level, your best bet is to run through the course again and keep taking photos, even of Pokemon you've already snapped, and submit them for a rating at the end of the course. Even if it's the same star rating, the points you acquire will go towards your point total. Of course, higher star ratings and new star ratings help if you're trying to fully complete the game. If you're looking for those 4-star photo opportunities and can't find them, getting to higher research levels is the way to go. Number 3, Photodex and Ratings. Speaking of photo grading, that's calculated a little differently this time around, although it's still the same idea. Both games judge the pose and size of the Pokemon. The original Pokemon Snap graded something called Technique, which has been replaced by Direction and Placement in New Pokemon Snap. The original Pokemon Snap gave you points if you had more of the same Pokemon in the shot, but New Pokemon Snap gives you extra points if there's more Pokemon in the shot regardless of which Pokemon it is. New Pokemon Snap also grades the background, but you don't always have control over that one. The key difference, though, is New Pokemon Snap gives you a star rating between 1 and 4 in each photo. The more unique and dynamic a Pokemon's actions are, the higher the star rating you'll get. However, the stars come in bronze, silver, gold, and platinum, so even if you got a Pokemon doing something unique, you'll only get 4 bronze stars if the photo is far away and not centered. There's also slots in the Photodex, this game's Pokédex, for 1 photo from each star rating, so you don't want to just get the best and move on. So basically, if you want to be the very best like no one ever was, you have to get cool shots that are also framed well. Number 4, Resnapping. After you get your photos evaluated, you can actually resnap the ones you plan to save to your own album, and that feature is new. The original Pokemon Snap also allowed you to save your personal favorites to an in-game album, but you couldn't edit them. With the advancement of photo editing tools over the past 22 years, it would make sense for the Pokemon Snap series to follow. In Resnap mode, you can adjust the brightness, blur, focus size, and focal point of the photo. You can also add a filter, rotate the photo, or even zoom in. Afterwards, you can also add stickers and filters to make the ultimate photo, and even share it online. I made this Talo with a hat and a light bulb over their head because why not? Lastly, the original game only lets you save 60 photos to your album, but in New Pokemon Snap, you can actually expand the size of your save data to save even more photos, which is really cool. Number 5, New Items. Okay, so great. Resnapping allows you to make the perfect photo afterward, but what can you do to boost your photo game when it comes to photo evaluations? Well, just like the original Pokemon Snap, as you progress through the story, you'll gain access to new tools that'll help you out. Just like the original, you'll get Fluff Fruits, which are basically softer and lighter apples that some Pokemon gravitate towards. And you'll receive a dash for the Neo 1 that makes it go faster through the courses, just like the original. You'll also receive a little music player that gets some Pokemon to do special actions like dancing. It's a bit like the Pokeflute in the original game, but this music player doesn't wake up sleeping Pokemon. New to New Pokemon Snap, I promise I'll stop making that joke, is the scan feature and the Lumina Orbs. The scan feature shows you nearby Pokemon and notable things like alternate routes. Scanning Pokemon might even cause them to do something unique, which makes for another great photo opportunity. Lumina Orbs are part of the story of this game, and they're similar to the Pester Balls from the original. Throwing them at a Pokemon makes them glow, and in the case of the Scorbunny, its flames change color too. Some Pokemon, like this one, also do something unique when you throw a Lumina Orb at it. A unique action and it's glowing? Professor Mira would love that. Number 6, Expanded Story and Characters. The last thing I'll talk about is the expanded story and characters, but don't get too excited, it's not much, unfortunately. Like the original game, you're helping a professor with taking research photos of Pokemon. This time you're researching something more specific, the Lumina phenomenon, and to avoid spoilers, I'll leave it there. Despite a paper-thin plot, having a story does help incentivize you to keep moving. After all, it was just you and Professor Oak in the original game, but now it's this new guy named Professor Mirror alongside a humble cast of other supporting characters. Aside from Professor Mirror, you have Rita, his research assistant, and Phil, who's supposed to be your rival, but you don't actually rival him in any way. To be honest, I don't exactly know why he's here, but he's here. There's also a fifth character, but I'm not going to spoil who that is, so you'll just have to find out for yourself. On top of that, there are more character customization options than in the original. In the original game, it was just the main dude, Todd Snap. But in this game, you can choose different genders, hair color, and skin color. However, outside of the 8 different preset options in the beginning, there's no further customization for things like clothes or accessories. So that's unfortunate given how much recent Pokemon games allowed you such options. Finally, new Pokemon Snap has voice acting for all its characters.
Try getting a shot of that Pokemon! You can press the A button to take a photo!
It's rather limited, but the fact that it's here is pretty cool. You can also turn off the voice acting if that's not your thing. While there are other minor additions to the formula like gyro controls and an expanded roster of Pokemon, what we highlighted in this video are ultimately the biggest changes we discovered between the two games. What do you think about the changes in new Pokemon Snap? Let us know in the comments, and if you find yourself getting stuck in the new game, I also made a video pointing out certain things you could do to get through that, since new Pokemon Snap can be pretty cryptic sometimes. For more on new Pokemon Snap and all the latest on Pokemon, stay tuned to GameSpot.